Hello, YouTube. My name is Phantom, and welcome to Madden Madness. This is the tournament that gives every team a chance. If you haven't watched, here is the bracket thus far. Today we have the Saints and the Panthers. The winner moves on, the loser goes home. We're at a neutral stadium in Gillette in Foxborough. Who do you think will win? Comment below. Like the video and subscribe for more. Without further ado, here we go. It is the first game of the season, so completely open stats. Anything can happen. Panthers will punt. Kickoff, I mean. And it's going to be caught for a touchback. Out comes Drew Brees. He has multiple records for completion percentage. This year he set the record for completion percentage in a season. He's doing pretty well for a little short guy, huh? And as a reminder, we will be keeping track of certain stats live. We're coming out in the running formation for the first play of Madden Madness. It's a run. He's down. Gain of 3. Just a simple power play. And here we have the Saints offensive line. Ingram and Kamara, everybody knows about them, with Thomas and Hill. The Saints have always been stacked on offense. Alright, they're going to break huddle. Two receivers to the right, one to the left, one running back. It's a throw for Breeze. And it's a drop. Ball was right in his hands and he dropped it. Here are the Panthers' defense. Luke Kuechly right there, leader of this defense. Third and 7 coming up. 6 minutes and 16 seconds left. Two backs, balance formation, Breeze will throw, flag down, Breeze is going to scramble, oh and he's walloped, it is a first down, we'll see what the flag is. Well, they're going to have to do that again from farther away. It's going to be a 3rd and 17. Peyton's very angry. Ball will be placed at the 18-yard line. We'll see if they can get a first down. Breeze will throw. Caught, but not a first down. Just a gain of 10. And the Saints will likely punt on their first drive, going 3 and out. And there's Ron Rivera congratulating his team. Now what they want to do is get Cam the ball and have him go down and score a touchdown. Punts away. Caught at the 15. And there's a flag on the field. Gain is 6. not Sterling Moore. Before the penalty, that was pretty good starting field position for the New Orleans, but with that penalty now, Carolina has the one with the good field position. We'll see what they'll do. Most teams tend to run to start off a game, but we'll see what happens. He will throw, and he misses his target. It was wide right. And New Orleans defense, they made a big change. They've been pretty bad for most of Bree's career, but this year they were, I want to say, top 15. Newton in the shotgun. He's going to pass. And it's incomplete. He's 0 for 2. 3rd and 10 coming up. The game's starting off a little bit defensively. Didn't really expect that. Newton, he's going to scramble, and he's going to slide down a little bit too early, gain a 4, but it's going to be a 4th and 6. They're going to punt again. There will be back-to-back punts. He might have had a chance to get that first down if he could have slipped that tackle, but he just decides to play it safe. He was injured all last year, so totally understand why. Away, it's going to bounce down in the end zone for a touchback. Just a little bit too much leg on that. And out comes New Orleans. And they're going to run it. Gain of 3 for Mark Ingram. Sets up a 2nd and 7. Breeze throws, incomplete, in the area of the receiver, but seemed to be just right. It's going to be a 3rd and long again. Saints are already 0 for 1 in 3rd downs. See if they can make it a 1 for 2. Breeze is going to throw. Complete. Big yardage. Gain of 23 out to the 46-yard line. Sean Payton looking pretty smug on the sidelines. Now they passed on the last play for a big gain. Will they remain with the pass, or are they going to go with the run? That was their big change in the offseason on the They will run it. Gain of 10. So, good pass, good run. And now they're into Carolina territory. He's going to throw. And was it caught? I think it was. Gain of 3. It was the rookie backup, Alvin Kamara. And Breeze in the shotgun all alone in the backfield. And very similar route, except for this time it gets a first down. Gain of 7. And it's Willie Snead. Just, if the deep ball's not there, take the check down. Good job by Breeze there. Slipped off 2 guys though. Good job. Gonna be 1st and 10. Just under a minute left in the first. Score is still 0-0. They're in a running formation. Running left. Stopped at the line, gain of nothing. Play clock and game clock are pretty much synchronized, so it's up to New Orleans if they want to run another play. Break the huddle with 10 seconds left on the play clock. And they're going to run it again. A little bit better, gain of 3. It's going to bring up a 3rd down, 3rd and 7. And that's it. The end of the first quarter. Score is 0-0. And we're back. Still Phantom here. Starting off the second quarter, 0-0. New Orleans has the ball. It's a 3rd and 7 coming up. This is their 3rd attempt on a 3rd down. Let's see. They're currently 1 for 3. Or 1 for 2. Breeze has the ball. He's going to throw it away. He's going to settle for 3 points. Field goal attempt coming up. It's a pretty far one. Kick is away, and it's good. 3-0 New Orleans opens up the scoring. Ron Rivera, Sean Payton. Saints are getting ready to kick it away. kick is away, and they're going to run it out of the end zone. Good return out to the 29. It's 4 yards more with the new rules than you would have gotten with a touchback for Whitaker. Newton and Funchess coming out to get to work. And they're trying to do better where last time they just got the three and out. Coming out in a running formation. Strong left. And he's got a hole, but he's down at the 36-yard line, gain of 7. Sets him up in good field position, head of the chains. Just a simple halfback dive, a little bit to the left. We call that a power. Newton comes back out. And we're going to have a pre-snap penalty. Who is this against? Neutral zone infraction, defense. Oh, and that's going to cause a first down. That's what the Saints have been like before this season. Just giving up yards and first downs like candy. Peyton's used to it. See if Carolina can now take advantage of this. If I'm Carolina, I'm going to run it again because the defensive linemen are going to be slow getting off the ball. I'd run right at them. That's what they're going to do. Big hole. Big hole. First down. Gain of 13. Stewart. Jonathan Stewart. And they're inching up on midfield. Coming out in ISO formation. Motion, running to the left, gain of 4 for Christian McCaffrey. Decent gain, you get 4 yards every time, that's a first down. Ten seconds left on the play clock as they come out. Gonna keep it running. Only gain of 8 or gain of 2 this time. I would not be very surprised to see a play action on this next play. Wide receivers bunch to the right. Newton. First down. It's Dickerson. Just a simple curl route. Halfback base, McCaffrey, big gain, 12 yards on the pickup. Newton's going to be under center on this snap. They're going to run it right. Gain of about 2. Seems that, well, Carolina can possibly run the clock most of the way down, but we're at the 2-minute warning. Three-zero, Carolina in the red zone. We're back now, it's 3-0. Panthers with the ball though. So 2nd and 8. Balance formation. Play action fake. Newton throws across his body. It's complete. Gain of 8 near a first down. 3rd and inches coming up. They're 1 for 2 now on 3rd down. Let's see if they can get this one. Newton's gonna throw. And he dropped it. He dropped it. Clock stops and New Orleans will definitely get the ball back now. You can't drop that. It's in your hands. Peyton's pleased. They're going to take an attempt for 3 from the right hash. Kick is good. 3-3. It's a tie game. 123 left in the second quarter. So far, only trading field goals. Balls away. Caught deep in the end zone. He's going to take the knee. Take the free 25 yards. So what's interesting so far is Panthers and Saints are both 1 for 3 on 3rd down. Very similar. Both teams are playing the other pretty much exactly the same. But I think it's going to take one field goals to win this one. The perfect drive for New Orleans. Get a touchdown when the clock hits zeros. Breeze with the ball. He's going to throw it off the slant. And it looks like to be caught. Gain of 8. 2nd and 2 coming up. Clock running. If you're the Saints, you want to start calling multiple plays in the huddle. Saints going to throw. Breeze in the shotgun. And drop. It's a drop. Stops the clock. 50 seconds left. Now Carolina has a chance to score if they can get a stop here on 3rd down. Saints are 1 for 3 on 3rd down so far. It's a short 2 yards. If I'm the Saints, I'm still going to throw it. A conservative call would be to run it. I would do a screen. Screen pass. But looks like they're going to come out. They're going to throw in formation. He's looking deep downfield. He's throwing it. He's got him in stride. New Orleans takes a timeout after the completion for a big gain. So now that brings their numbers to 2-for-4 on third down. Michael Thomas with 2 catches. Of course, one of those 2 catches were for big yards. New Orleans with 44 seconds left to see if they can make it 10-3 at the half. At the 38. Brees going to come out alone in the shotgun again. He's going to throw. Caught on the sideline. Gain of 4, and now they have to take a timeout. Wouldn't agree very much with that timeout call. I'm surprised they didn't stop the clock for him being out of bounds. I thought he was out of bounds. Well, if you skipped ahead in the video, New Orleans and Carolina have played each other pretty much equally, settling for field goals after 3 and outs on each of their drives. And now it's 3-3, but New Orleans has a chance to get a touchdown to get up 10-3 at the half. Now comes New Orleans. They're in the edge of field goal range, but they want more than that. They want 7. And Brees throws it over the head of his receiver. And up comes a 3rd and 6. Two for four on third down so far. And it's converted. It's the tight end Hill. And they will hurry back to the line. Panthers get to him. It's a sack. Luke Kuechly. And the clock's going to run. They're going to let it run down. New Orleans is going to take a timeout with 10 seconds left. Try and get a field goal unit out there. And try and make it 6-3. Second and 15 coming up for New Orleans, but they're probably just going to kick the field goal, and they will. Kick is away, and it's good. New Orleans is up 6-3 at the half. Well, it's not quite the half. We got 7 seconds. But, yep. Not dead center, but pretty kick. Newton's throwing, but he knows he ain't gonna use that arm till third quarter. Kick is away. and it's in Cotton bounds. He's going to run it up. Looks to be a gain of 25 yards on the punt, or on the kick. 3 seconds left. Carolina should just knee it. Looks like they're going to kneel it, and that should be it for the first half. 6-3, and we're going to skip halftime, so we'll be back sooner than you think. It'll be Carolina's ball to start the second half. And they're back, ready to return the kick. Kicks away. Caught on the goal line. He's going to run it out. Jukes the defender, and he's down at the 23. He couldn't take the knee there, otherwise he would have gotten an extra 2 yards, but when you catch him on the goal line like that, you pretty much have to run him out because you don't want to take the risk that you're not in the end zone and you don't want to get stuck at the 1 yard line, or even worse, giving up a touchdown. So Panthers will break the huddle now. New Orleans has doubled Carolina's yards. They're going to hand it off. He lost a yard. 2nd and 11 coming up. That play went nowhere. Blown up. There's just no hole there. Comes out. Strong left, and they're going to run it left, but he gets contacted behind the line. Stewart's able to fall forward, though, for a gain of 2. Going to be a 3rd and long coming up. They're 1 for 3 so far. Clock's running. Under 2-3 seconds. And he's gonna dump it off. And that's nothing. Nothing happened. Net gain of 0. 4th and 9 coming up. So they're 1 for 4 on 3rd down. While the Saints are 3 for 5. So their offense just isn't moving. That's the main reason they're down in this one. Their defense is doing their job holding New Orleans, which is a perennial top 5 offense, to 6 points in the first half. Kicks away. That's a big boomer. Oh, and he's going to get some yards. Return to the 32, and that's where New Orleans will start their drive. Breeze hops on out here. He hasn't thrown a touchdown yet, but he hasn't thrown any interceptions either. They've been able to move into the red zone on both of their scoring drives, but not enough. Let's see if they can get in for 6. They're going to hand it off. And it's a gain of 4 for Kamara. His first rush of the game. Decent pickup on first down. It's going to set up a second and manageable. Second and 6 coming up. Wide receivers bunched to the left side. And it's a misdirection, and he's got nobody in the zip code. Gain of 13 for Ingram. Seems like every game either Ingram going off or Kamara is going off. Just a simple misdirection. Right to the right, I guess. It's almost 2-1 in their pass-to-run ratio. They're going to run it again up the gut, and he's got another big hole. Gaining a lot. Just about 12 yards, I believe. If they can just run it down their throats the entire game, that means they're going to have a much larger time of possession, which gives Cam Newton a lot less time to beat him. So, productive run game is very good. And it's a play action fake. Should have seen that coming. There's a flag on the field, though. If it isn't against New Orleans, it's going to be a gain of about 7. But we'll see what the flag is first. Just a total momentum killer holding on the offense. And they're back at the 50-yard line. So not only does that set them back 10 yards, erase their previous play, now they're also back out of field goal range. But luckily it's still first down, so if they can get a good chunk on first down, they should be okay, but in the NFL, nothing's guaranteed, right? And they're going to run it up the gut. Gain of only 1, so it's going to be a second and very long. See, and that's what I was talking about before. New Orleans is winning the time of possession battle because they're able to run it up the gut. But they aren't scored only on time of possession, so Carolina's not completely out of it. They're going to hand it off up the gut again. Gain of about 5 for Kamara. 3rd and 14 coming up. Balance formation, 2 wide receivers on each side. Breeze is going to throw. Dump off pass. And he's going to settle for the long field goal attempt. Ball is moved up to the 38 of Carolina. So now that makes them 3 for 6 on third down. About 50%, not terrible. Very long field goal attempt coming up. And it's short and left. It's no good. Score remains 6-3 with 6 seconds left in the third. It's no gimme. You can't just assume that you're going to make it every time you kick it from that far. Just left and a little bit short as well. Carolina's back in business. They got great field position as they prepare for the last play of the third quarter. Balanced formation again. Awkward snap, but Newton gets it off. It's a gain of about, what, 7. And that's it for the third. Score 6-3. And we're back. 6-3, Saints. Panthers with the ball, trying to tie or maybe pull ahead. And they've got great field position. 2nd and 3 coming up. Now this is a down and distance where you can just chuck it if you want. It's almost like a free down. Receivers bunch to the left. And we're going to have a pre-snap penalty. That's the second time this game that they've given up a first down on a penalty. Yep. That's killer. You cannot do that in the NFL. And as they get started, I think it's fair to explain why we're in Patriots land. So, I wanted this to be at a neutral field. So, it would be the most fair. Newton. He's scrambling. Throws across his body. He's got the first down. Ball's down at the 32. So what I was saying before was so the AFC and the NFC teams that went to the Super Bowl, the Patriots and the Eagles, those will be the sites of the conference, of the opposite conference where the games will be played. So all the NFC games will be played here at Gillette, and Lincoln Financial Field will be for the AFC, so all about fairness here. As Newton scrambles up the gut, he's got a big gainer. He's inside the red zone, down at the 8-yard line. That's the biggest play of the game, I believe. Just nothing. He knows it's man coverage, and when it's man coverage, you can get away with some big runs as the QB. Stewart missed. If he gets a better block to the players on the right side, that's a touchdown. Nevertheless, 8 yards to go, first and goal. Just about 5.5 minutes left. Running it up the gut. Gain of only 1. So now it's a little bit harder. Newton's gonna pass on this play. Newton throws, nearly intercepted, just about picked off. Number 51, Monte Teo, with the dropped interception. Great play by him, diving and getting that ball, because if he doesn't dive and hit that ball to the turf, that's definitely a touchdown. So now it's 3rd and long, by red zone standards. It's 3rd and long no matter what, I suppose. 3rd and 7 yards to the end zone as Newton comes out in the throwing formation. Running formation, actually, under center. He's going to step back, 5-10 step drop. He's going to scramble, and he's sacked. He's down. Sacked at the 11-yard line. Hendrickson with the sack. And it's just amazing how the Saints have finally got their defense together. It's just been terrible for what, the past half decade, if not more. Good for New Orleans. Carolina's going to settle for three here and make it a tied ball game, barring some crazy mishap. Kicks away, and it's good. So 6-6 with less than 4 minutes to play. Now, if Saints can have the perfect drive, they can run the clock down, kick a game-winning field goal, or get a game-winning touchdown. But that's still a long ways away by football standards. Is away, caught in the end zone. He's gonna run it out. He's only gonna get it to about 26. Net gain of one. 28-yard return. Let's see what New Orleans can do. Coming out in a running formation. Some pre-snap motion. Play action fake. There's a flag down. And the ball's incomplete. Just a little bit to the side and a little bit underthrown by Breeze. Another holding offense call. Max Unger this time. And that, once again, is another momentum killer. But Saints can overcome, technically. Breeze is coming out in the shotgun. Breeze. Caught. Check down. 1 yard gain to the 17. They're going to say it's a 2nd and 18 coming up. Now, you can't take checkdowns when it's a 2nd and 18, so we'll see what Breeze can do, if they can get open downfield. Running formation once again. Gonna run it up the gut, a little bit to the left. Gain of only one, Mark Ingram. 3rd and 18 coming up from the 18. They're 3 for 6 so far, 50%, not too bad. But this is a 3rd and 18, let's see what they can do. Breeze in the shotgun, Breeze takes the snap, throws it way downfield. And it's over the head, incomplete. So 4th down, and clock stops, Carolina will get the ball back. Now, if you're Carolina, you're going to get the ball with decent field position, and you can also take that field position and drive down the field and score that game-winning field goal or touchdown. And that's a big kick. Down to the 27. Only 3 yards per return. They're doing well on special teams. Let's see if Newton can overcome this lockdown defense. And you got to think, you touchdown would pretty would give a really good chance to seal it, because a field goal, that means they're only going half the length of the field. And you can do that pretty quickly. Snaps away, big hole, big run. Trucks the defender up to the 41. Jonathan Stewart. Just, the Panthers won the line of scrimmage right there. Oh, and that hit. Check him for a concussion. Bam. Boom. And this should be the last play before the 2-minute warning, unless it's an incomplete pass. Newton takes the snap, fires. Gain of 9 to the 50-yard line. Second down and 1. But we're at the 2-minute warning. We'll be right back and see the end of this after this. And we're back at 6-6. Panthers with the ball at midfield. Let's take this time to remind you, subscribe if you want to see more games like this, and thanks for watching. Alright, second and 1 coming up. Snap to Newton, fires, and he had it in his hands for a second, but it's dropped. Clock will stop with 1 minute 56 left. 3rd and 1 coming up. And Panthers have really struggled on 3rd down. It's they're 1 for 5 on 3rd down. Let's see if they can convert another 3rd down. Biggest one of the game thus far. Newton's going to throw. He's going to scramble. He's got the 1st down and more. Newton, gain of 14, slides down, clock's going to continue to roll. He must have seen that it must have been man coverage. Survey sees that it's man, scrambles out there, and takes what he can get. Good play by Newton. That could be the play of the game right there, depending on how the rest of this goes. But, oh, we're going to have a false start penalty on Carolina. False start. Offense. That was the left side of the lineman, number 68. I was a lineman. And you know what they told us to avoid false starts? Look at the ball. When the ball snaps, the play's live. When it doesn't snap, it's not live. But my coach always would prefer false starts to neutral zone infractions. So. Front set right. Newton in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Fires. And it's complete for the 1st down. Saints are going to take a timeout. Try and preserve some clock here. Because Carolina has a really good chance of scoring. We'll be back. And we're back. Peyton crossing his arms, unhappy with this predicament now. Now he's likely going to have a comeback after having the lead for most of the game. Coming out in a jumbo formation. And they're going to run it up the gut. Good run. Gain of 6. And we're going to get another timeout taken by New Orleans. We'll be back. right now. Just kidding. Second and four coming up. Clock is stopped. New Orleans has one timeout left. So if I'm Carolina, I'm going to run it one more time and see what we can get. And then I might actually, no. I was going to say throw it then, but why would you do that? It's going to be probably third and short. So just run it up the gut and see what you can get. You can win this game if you get this first down. New Orleans. Newton. First down. And it's going to be a first and goal. New Orleans spends its last time out, and they need a miracle here. It's not looking good. And we're back to see this one out. Carolina. The best thing for New Orleans to do here is to give up a quick touchdown. And then they have a chance to answer, because otherwise Carolina's going to run it once, run the clock down, run once more, and then kick the game-winning field goal. But maybe New Orleans is thinking turnover. Oh, pancake up to everything. Touchdown. Touchdown, Carolina. That's his first rushing touchdown. Stewart. So, first touchdown of Madden Madness near the end of the first game. Just walks it in. Hardly touched. It was that blocking up front that really sold it. Unless those players are flopping, trying to get the ball back quickly. And here comes the extra point. It's good. 13-6 Carolina. With 1 minute, 9 seconds left. And if New Orleans wants to continue its stay in Madden Madness, it better score here. Kicks away. Takes the knee. Free 25 yards. And New Orleans prepares for what is probably going to be the final drive of the game. This. The last close game that New Orleans was in was that crazy finisher against Minnesota with that miracle play, Case Keenum to, I'm blanking on the name, you can tell me in the comments, I'm blanking, anyways, Breeze with the throw, they're gonna hurry up now as the clock runs under 1 minute, second and four. Thrown. Big game, but he's out of bounds. Got the ball, but not in time for his feet to hit the ground. Third down coming up. Third down. 3 for 8 on attempts, and they're good for another one. The drive will stay alive. They'll keep it marching. Under 40 seconds to play. And they're going to spike it. Stop the clock. with 37 seconds left. Second down coming up. Now, if I'm New Orleans, I might just take my deep shots now. You have to take your deep shots at least before 30 seconds. You want to have a chance to get up and spike the ball. Other options to try try to get one of those sideline shots, a bench play or a corner strike. They're going to take a little check down. He's going to get what he can get. And then he's going to step out. They're at midfield. 32 seconds left. And if I'm Carolina, that's almost a perfect play, honestly. If you can keep him from staying out of bounds or getting out of bounds, then you can keep the clock running and probably win this game. So almost perfect, but not quite. Breeze is likely going to throw here. Middle of the field is pretty open. Going to throw. He's got him. They're down at the 21. It's time to get that spike off. And the clock stops, 15 seconds left. All right, let's see it. Breeze has been in plenty of these situations, hasn't he? He's got to get it in there. That's what she said. Anyways, he's coming out in the shotgun because we all know it's a pass, obviously. Breeze. And sack. He's sacked. And that's probably going to do it. Hurrying back to the line for quick little play, but I don't think it's going to be enough. And that's it. Saints are the first team eliminated in Madden Madness. 6-13. What a great game. Breeze won't talk to anybody. He's uncharacteristically pissed. So, that's going to do it for Madden Madness. For me, I'm Phantom. Once again, subscribe if you want to see some more, and let's see the updated brackets. I believe this is the one. Yep, same. They're going to play the winner of the Falcons and the Bucks, so stay tuned for that. And once again, leave a like if you enjoyed it. And that's it. Final score, 6-13, Panthers.